in my government, but I think in all governments. So it's basically taking the next step in sort of 100 years of diplomacy and saying, in a world where technology companies outweigh our traditional partners, the nation states, in economic size, many of them would be G20 members if they were actually nation states, in political influence, we've seen how Silicon Valley have stood up to, for example, some of the things coming out of Washington over the last year or two. But not least also in the way that technology companies impact literally billions of people around the world. We've seen that not least the last couple of weeks with the Cambridge Analytica case. How do you rethink the way a government, a country, caretakes its interest and promotes its values abroad? There may be actually not so innovative solution to that coming from a foreign ministry is obviously we need a technology embassy, or we need a tech ambassador to try and strike up a conversation and create a new kind of language with the tech sector. So basically this is what the Danish government decided to do, we believe, as the first country in the world last year. So we appointed an ambassador, Kasper, who is posted with me in Palo Alto, so our headquarters is in Palo Alto, but we're a little bit different than other diplomatic missions because we have offices also in Copenhagen, in Beijing, and in China. So what we think a lot about is how do you incorporate ethics, how do you think about technology, data, digitalization, winners and losers the next 20, 30 years. From a foreign policy perspective. So we try and massage technology and innovation into the way we use our development funds, try and fund startups, try and fund technological solutions that are in demand around the world, but also in terms of geopolitics, in terms of making sure that we bridge the digital divide that is seen today in continents like Africa, for example. So this is the core of technology, trying to think about technology ethics and geopolitics from a sort of technology lens.